In this video, we will speak about whether defibrillation may be used in the case of asystole. Cardiac arrest is a stop of the blood flow caused by the failure of the heart to pump the blood effectively. This condition is diagnosed when the cardiac pulse is absent. Cardiac rhythms during cardiac arrest are divided into shockable and non-shockable. Shockable rhythms include ventricular fibrillation and pulseless ventricular tachycardia. Non-shockable rhythms include asystole and pulseless electrical activity. There is an uncoordinated contraction of cardiac muscle cells in the case of shockable rhythms. This leads to the absence of an effective ventricular contraction. Thus, the blood is not ejected from the ventricle, leading to the stop of the blood flow. The electrical activity of cardiomyocytes is uncoordinated. According to current guidelines, shockable cardiac rhythms should be treated with a defibrillator. The defibrillator performs a shock leading to the synchronous depolarization of all cardiomyocytes. Usually, after this, work of all cardiomyocytes becomes synchronous. The ventricle's contraction becomes effective and the ventricles eject the blood. Usually, the normal sinus rhythm is restored. In the case of asystole, there is no electric activity of the cardiomyocytes. ECG reveals the flat line, also called isoline. In the case of true asystole, the ventricles neither contract nor fibrillate. The defibrillator cannot restore the normal heart rhythm in the true asystole because there is no electric activity, and the defibrillator works only at the coordination of cardiac muscle cells depolarization. It's well known that in the case of asystole, patients' prognosis is much worse than in the case of ventricular fibrillation or pulseless ventricular tachycardia. But often, asystole is misdiagnosed with the ventricular fibrillation. This is caused by either disabled electrodes from the patient's body or breakdown of ECG monitor or undetected too small fibrillation waves. Often in the patients with an increased body weight, the fine waves such as in the ventricular fibrillation are hidden. In this case, asystole is diagnosed instead of the ventricular fibrillation. This is ventricular fibrillation masked in the asystole. In such case, the defibrillation would be effective. To make a correct diagnosis, echocardiography is used. In the case of ventricular fibrillation or ventricular tachycardia, echocardiography reveals fibrillation or quivering of the ventricles without an effective contraction. Fast performed, echocardiography may take only 5 seconds, and it allows to make the correct diagnosis and to choose an appropriate management. Management of shockable and non-shockable rhythms is different. In the case of shockable rhythms, except chest compressions, mechanical ventilation, and usage of epinephrine, defibrillation, and amiodarone are used. The last drug improves the efficiency of defibrillation. In the case of non-shockable rhythms, management is based on chest compressions, mechanical ventilation, and usage of epinephrine. Also, reversible causes should be corrected. According to field study, 35% of patients with asystole had coordinated cardiac motion. It was associated with better survival. Their articles describing cases of an immediate shock treatment of the asystole leading to the restoration of normal heart rhythm. Use of the echocardiography in the patients with asystole would improve diagnosis and thus survival. In the false asystole, when a patient has ventricular fibrillation, the defibrillation may restore sinus heart rhythm. But in current guidelines, it isn't recommended to use the defibrillator in the case of asystole. Probably you saw in movies that the defibrillator was used in the case of a flatline heart rhythm with successful restoration of the sinus rhythm. Can the defibrillator be effective in the case of asystole detected at ECG monitor? We hope that you can answer this question.
Thanks for watching this video. Please comment, subscribe, and hit the like button.